the camera? Is it on? Is it working? Is you recording?
Good morning, A-Town. I'm Josh, and it's February 24th. Here's what's happening at A-Town today. Next Tuesday, the 28th, the Tri-M Music Honor Society will be hosting a coffee house in the AHS cafeteria from 6 to 8 p.m. We will have drinks, food, games, and live music. Donations are appreciated and will go to Mr. G. We hope you can join us. If you're looking for something to do this weekend, check out Winter Songs. Winter Songs is a benefit concert which raises money for the Shelter for Help in Emergency. Since its debut in 2015, Winter Songs has raised more than $30,000 to assist local women in crisis. The Winter Songs concert will take place at Monticello High School this Saturday, February 25th at 5 p.m. Admission is free, but donations to the Shelter for Help in Emergency are encouraged and appreciated. And now here's Ms. Newman with another talent development update.
Hi, it's Ms. Newman, your talent development resource teacher here at Albemarle High School with your Talent Thursday update. I'm going to bring you lots of opportunities to grow outside the classroom in 2 minutes or less. Here we go. First up, I've got the National Youth Science Camp. This is a hybrid camp going on at Camp Pocahontas in West Virginia. It spans from June through July. Part of it is at home and virtual, and part of it is in person. And your application for this is due February the 28th. It looks like your housing, meals, transportation, and supplies are provided for free at no cost. If you are selected, and I think 2 delegates per state are selected. So that could be you. Get your application in if you're interested in National Youth Science Camp. Check it out. Seniors. I don't even know where to start with seniors, but I've got scholarships. So I've got the Granville Mead Scholarship coming up due March the 3rd. I've got Electric Cooperative Scholarships coming up due April the 3rd. I've got the local over in Orange in Gordonsville, Sally Lamb Memorial Oakland Heights Farm Four Horseshoes Foundation. If you are an equestrian and you show at the Virginia Horse Show Association, you can earn yourself up to a $1,000 scholarship. That is due April the 30th. I've got the UVA Credit Union Scholarship, UVA Community Credit Union Scholarship, due March the 10th. I've got the Thomas Jefferson Soil and Water Scholarship coming up due April the 5th. I've got the Allen and Allen Scholarship due March the 3rd. I've got Dominion Energy Credit Union that offers $2,000 scholarships. Or if you're in Rappahannock's region, they've got some scholarship opportunities too. I've also got a list of Virginia colleges that have upcoming deadlines. So if you have not applied to schools yet but are still wanting to attend college, check out Longwood, Hampton University, Randolph-Macon, the University of Lynchburg, Roanoke College, Emory and Henry, Norfolk State, and Virginia State University. And then I've got your deadlines there. Come see me if you need help with those college essays. What else am I going to talk about? I'm running out of time. I have to talk about the 1890 National Scholarship Program. If you're a junior or a senior, you should check this out. This is sponsored by the U.S. Department of Agriculture, USDA, and it offers scholarships to U.S. citizens seeking a bachelor's degree at a land-grant university in the field of food, agriculture, natural resource sciences, or related disciplines. They give you full tuition. That's right, I said full tuition, fees, books, room and board, and a summer internship, which may convert into a full-time employment opportunity with the U.S. Department of Agriculture after graduation at these universities over here on the left-hand side, including Virginia State University, which is in Petersburg, that's just outside of Richmond, and West Virginia State University. You got to get your applications in by March the 15th. That is a fantastic program. Oh, what else am I going to do? All right, I got 30 seconds more. I'm going to go with 11th graders. Check out the Caminos al Futuro program, which is a fully funded pre-college residential summer program. So you would actually live on a college campus at George Washington University, which is in Washington, D.C. Their applications close March the 1st. To be eligible, you need to be a current 11th grader, that's rising senior, at a U.S. high school with a high level of academic achievement and a demonstrated commitment to service as well as leadership, and within the Latino Hispanic community. It is a 3-week program, but it is free, and you get a firsthand view of policymaking in the nation's capital. So if you're into government, check it out. Okay, that's all I got. My 2 minutes are up. I'll be back next Tuesday. See you soon.
In sports news, the boys basketball team came to a sad but very exciting end on Wednesday night when they dropped another nail biter to Potomac Falls and regional tournament play. Congratulations to the whole team on a fantastic season. Special congratulations are due to Carter Weston, who was named the Jefferson District Basketball Player of the Year by members of the local sports media. Carter will be joined on the first team by all district roster by Lamari Pollard and his brother Ben Weston. Christian Humes and Noah Grievous were given second team honors. Lauren Grady of the girls' basketball team was named second team to All-Jefferson squad. Kaylee Maynard and Sophia Lynn are honorable mentions. 11 Patriot indoor track athletes will be traveling to Virginia Beach this weekend to compete in the state indoor track championships. Good luck to all our track and field athletes. That's all for now. I'm Josh. See you tomorrow on A-Town Today.